times together.
Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato.
Today, I choose so that particular so that through our strength and grace, you know, taken from Sanda Nidaya Mahavaka, so that particular so that Sanda Nagami Pala so that Nagami Pala so that and Arata Pala so that. Actually, I have already talked about this sutta since long time ago in this monastery. After opening ceremony of this monastery, then we give the Dhamma talk. Here, then I studied with this sutta. Okay, and also, actually, I talk about this sutta in many countries, for example, in Singapore, Indonesia, Taiwan, China, etc. But, and then there are many news meditators and our meditation centers. So I also need to share this sutras to the new meditators, those who haven't listened to this Dhamma yet. That's why I choose this sutras to explain. So that would be the last of that. That through our strength and dream. If someone wants to become Sotapanna or Sotapadipala Sota, okay, the Buddha mentioned Sotapadipala Sota. In the same way, there are also Sakatapadipala Sota, you know. After this sutta, there will be Sakadagami plus sutta. That's the same. If someone wants to begin Sakadagami, scan over persons, then they should also follow this way. After the Sakadagami sutta, the Buddha talk about Anagami plus sutta. This is also the way to become anagami. Then the Buddha continued to talk about Arahata Palasoda, the fruit of arahantship. If someone wants to become arahanta, they also need to follow according to this soda's instructions. So those are noble persons. If you wish to become a noble person, okay, so that but not all higher noble persons, what should you do? Okay, you should try to follow the sutta's instruction taught by the Buddha. and this sutta and these suttas. How does a Buddha talk to be the Sotapanna or Thayanubhavasa and this sutta? Oh, yeah. The sutta is very short. Only you just try to follow according to the sutta's instruction, then you will become Sotapanna or Thayanubhavasa up to Arahanta stage. Then, you just finish Pali class. So, you are familiar with Pali tongues. I will recite Pali, this sutta is Pali first. Then, we will explain one by one. If you wish to recite, you can also recite, okay? Chadamami bhikkhave dhamma bhavida buligata sota pati pala sichi kriyaya samodandi kadame chadaro sapurisa sanjivo sadama savanam yoni so manasikaro dhamma nu dhamma patipati ime kho bhikkhave chadaro dhamma bhavida buligata sota pati pala sichi kriyaya samodandi. When you can follow this sutta's instruction, you can begin Sotapanna or Hayana Vipassana. Then, Sakadagami Phalasutta, you can only change. You know, Chadarame Vikave Dhamma Bhavita Bhuligata Sakadagami Phalasichi Kriyaya Samvodandi Kadame Chadaro Samvurisa Sanjivo Sadama Savana Yandiso Manasikaro Dhamma Nukama Vadipati Ime ko bhikkhave chadaro dhamma bhavida buligata sagadagami phala sichi kriyaya samvodandi. Then, when you can follow this sutta's instruction, you can also begin sagadagami vipassana. Then, if you wish to begin anagami vipassana, how we will change? Anagami phala sichi kriyaya samvodandi. And then you become familiar with this sutta, then I hope you will be able to recite Bhikkhu Sai for Anagami, Siyali Sai for Arahanta. Because many Siyali want to become Arahanta. Okay, recite, you can see here very clear. Bhikkhu, only just Bhikkhu for Anagami. Thank you. only just listen to the Dhamma talk. After the Dhamma talk, they all forget. They all forget. That's why I also ask you to try to memorize. Okay? What is the meaning? I only just recite two sutta. Then you recite Anagamipada sutta, you recite Aratapada sutta, apparently you recite this and continue to practice. Until, okay? You become Arahanta. Okay? Then, yeah. This is the English translation. Because these four things, when developed and cultivated, lead to the realization of the fruit of strength and freedom. What four? Number one, association with superior persons. Number two, hearing the true Dhamma. Number three, careful attention or proper attention, wise attention. Number four, practice in accordance with the Dhamma. These four things, when developed and cultivated, lead to the realization of the fruit of strength and tree. Or the fruit of strength and tree is sort of a deep color. Okay? Bhikkhu, the Buddha used bhikkhu or bhikkhave. Generally, bhikkhu. The Buddha only used bhikkhu. Why the Buddha used only just bhikkhu? When the Buddha does not use as Bhikkhuni or Upasaka or Upasika? Huh? Why? And the Buddha see only just Bhikkhu's face. Huh? He follow Agati. You think like this? Actually, the Bhikkhu regard to all lessons. Okay? One day, this is another explanation, another definition. Also, you know, when the Buddha, after taking pre-nirvana, then the Buddha, you know, his desire, among his desire, bhikkhu were carrying on his sasana for long time. Because of this reason, the Buddha used bhikkhu. Okay? Then, don't be disappointed. Shall we disappoint you? You know, the Buddha, how do you call it? Differences between male and female. Don't do like this. Okay? If you wish to become a bhikkhu, okay, you can become a bhikkhu. Next time, don't worry. This is not human rights. Not Western idea. You know, when we went to USA last year, then we set up the CIMA. When we were doing the CIMA sitting, then one lady asked, we cannot participate in this CIMA sitting or not? Then how we answer? You know? Oh, you can also participate, you can answer the nimitta. What is the nimitta? In this direction, east direction, stone, Pasano Bhandin. Oh, this is the nimitta. Then they can also answer it. But they cannot recite Kamavata. Okay? Actually, they also want to join in the sunglass to sit the sima. But we all, okay, you can participate, you can answer the Sima stroke, okay? Prati Maya Desire, okay, Nimeta, or people ask, what is the Nimeta in the east direction? Then we also can answer, Pasano Bandit, Stone Bandit. Stone is the Sima Nimeta in east direction, like this, okay? It must be serious with this, because of participate. But they cannot recite Kamavasa. Please be patient with this condition. Okay? And the Buddha used bhikkhus. Because he know Bhikkhu were maintain this sasana for long time, not to disappear. Okay? Then here, now you are practicing meditations. What is the purpose for the practicing of meditation? To realize Nibbana. What is the purpose of meditation practice? To realize Nibbana. Why do you want to realize Nibbana? Okay, to escape from suffering, dukkha. To escape from suffering, to be free from suffering. So you know what are suffering? Oh, everybody knows. The Buddha also mentioned many different kinds of suffering and many sutta. For example, Matsipurana sutta, the Majjhaka Bodhana sutta, etc. Chadibi dukkha, birth is suffering, Jarabi dukkha, aging is suffering, Vyadibi dukkha, sickness is suffering, Maranabi dukkha, death is suffering, etc. So nobody wants to experience those many types of suffering. So if you don't want to experience those many types of suffering, what should you do? You need to try to realize Nibbana. In other words, you need to try to penetrate the Four Noble Truths. Okay? To penetrate the Four Noble Truths. Without realization, or without penetration of the Four Noble Truths, nobody can escape from suffering. So if you wish to escape from suffering, you need to try to penetrate the Four Noble Truths. How do you find to penetrate the Four Noble Truths? You need to follow the way, you know, you need to follow the way that can penetrate the Four Noble Truths. You know, you need to follow to those who have already penetrated the Four Noble Truths. Who have penetrated the Four Noble Truths? Noble persons. Who are noble persons? Oh, yeah. Sotapanna, Sakadagami, Anagami, and Arahanta. They are noble persons. Ariya, persons. So, they also penetrate the Four Noble Truths. They have already penetrated the Four Noble Truths. They realized Nibbana. They have realized Nibbana. So if you wish to realize Nibbana, if you wish to penetrate the Four Noble Truths, or if you wish to become Sotapanna or higher noble person, you only just need to try to follow their way. How did they become Sotapanna or higher noble persons? By following these four conditions. Okay? By fulfilling these four conditions, they became Sotapanna or higher noble persons. So if you wish to become noble persons like them, then you also need to try to follow their way. Okay? You need to try to fulfill the four conditions that lead to realization of Nibbana. Okay? What are four conditions? What are four necessary factors to become Sotapanna or higher noble person? What are preliminary factors? What are required factors to become Sotapanna or higher noble persons? Number one, Sabrisa Sansiwa, association with superior persons. Okay? Association with superior persons. Number two, Sadama Sawana, hearing the true Dhamma. Number three, Yoni Somanasi Karo, careful attention, proper attention, or wise attention. Number four, Dhamma Lu Dhamma Pati Pati, practice in accordance with the Dhamma. Altogether, four conditions that lead to realization of Nirvana. Since they have fulfilled these four conditions, or they also became Sotapanna or higher noble persons. So in the same way, if you wish to become Sotapanna or higher noble persons, you also need to fulfill these four conditions that lead to realization of Nirvana. Okay? Samurita Sansi War, association with superior persons, association with good persons. What is association with superior persons? If you wish to become Sotapanna or higher noble person, you need to associate with superior persons, good persons. Who are superior persons, good persons? The Buddha and Buddha's disciples. Oh. Why Buddha and Buddha disciples are good persons, superior persons? They know, they can show the way for realization of Nirvana. Okay? Other persons, the persons outside of the Buddha's dispensation, it is impossible to teach the way for realization of Nirvana. That's why in this case, they are not superior person or good person. Buddha and Buddha's disciple can teach the Dhamma which lead to realization of Nirvana. Okay? So when you associate with Buddha and Buddha's disciple, what will happen? You will be able to know the way to realize Nirvana. They will teach the way to realize Nirvana. So, you know, the commentary mentions, if you wish to become Sotapanna or higher noble persons, first, you need to associate with the Buddha. It is better. What? When you associate with the Buddha, what happens? Sure, at the end of one sentence, even at the end of one sentence, you can become Sotapanna or higher noble persons. You know, there are many persons who became Sotapanna or higher noble person as after listening to one stanza from the Buddha during the Buddha times. You want to know who are they? Many. Many. Many human beings, many bhikkhu, many devas. They began noble persons. Even before becoming a noble person, what happened? They were very bad persons. For example, like Venerable Angulimala, he killed many human beings. 999 human beings. Although he killed a lot of human beings, after listening to the Dhamma from the Buddha, he began noble persons. He began Arahanta. Understand? Also, there are many beings who became Sotapanna or higher noble persons. You can see in the Dhammapada story, after listening in the Dhamma, they began to be persons. Whenever we hear, oh, most of the great disciples, after listening to the Buddha's Dhamma, they began to be persons. Easy. Why? They can associate with the Buddha. Now, the Buddha already took, the Buddha has taken Pranibbana. So, you cannot associate with the alive Buddha, real Buddha. How do you do? Then you cannot listen, look, you cannot listen to the Dhamma from the Buddha directly. That's why you have no chance to become a real person after listening to the Dhamma. Okay? If you can associate with the Buddha, if you meet with the Buddha, sure, you can also listen to the Dhamma from the Buddha. After listening to the Dhamma from the Buddha, you can also become Sotapanna or higher noble person. But you missed this chance. You missed this opportunity. So you cannot associate with the real Buddha. But although you cannot associate with the real Buddha, don't worry, when you develop the Buddha's quality, okay, when you offer the flower, candlelight, food to the Buddha, by paying attention to the real Buddha, or you also have a kind of opportunity to be with the Buddha, okay? Then you are also meeting with the Buddha, although you cannot listen, you cannot listen to the Dhamma from the Buddha. Okay? You know, Buddha says, Venerable Wakili, your Dhammapasati, Somapasati. If someone see the Dhamma, or they can also see the Buddha. Okay? Your Dhammapasati, Somapasati. So if you wish to meet the Buddha, or if you wish to see the Buddha, try to realize the Dhamma. Trying to attain the Dhamma, especially Lokottara Dhamma. When you have attained Lokottara Dhamma, then you also see the Buddha, you also meet the Buddha. Whenever you want to pay attention to the Buddha's quality, you will feel you are meeting with the Buddha, real Buddha. Oh, you have such kind of chance. Okay? Then another one. If you cannot associate with the Buddha, you should associate with correct disciples, maybe chief disciples like Venerable Sai Buddha and Venerable Moggallana. Or correct disciples like Venerable Kassapa, Venerable Ananda, etc. If you can associate with those kinds of noble persons, sure, they will teach the way to realize Nibbana. Then there are also many persons, many noble persons who became a noble person by associating with Venerable Sariputta, Venerable Moggallana, etc. Okay? So you also miss this chance to associate with chief disciple and great disciple. They have also taken Pranibbana, maybe during, not so long after taking Pranibbana of the Buddha. So you also missed this chance. Don't worry, if you cannot associate with those Mahasavaka and Ekasavaka and Mahasavaka, then you should associate with Arahanta person. Oh, when you can associate with Arahanta, this is the best. If you cannot find Arahanta, or if you cannot associate with the Arahanta, you should associate with Anagami Pasen. If you cannot associate with anagami present, okay, another step, sagadagami present. When you cannot associate with sagadagami present, associate with sotapanna present. Oh, it is good. When you can associate with nobe present, shua, they will teach the way. They will teach the ways for realization of nirvana. Because of that they have, since they have already realized nirvana, they can also show the way to realize nirvana. So you should also associate with such kinds of noble persons. Okay? Then when by association with the noble person, okay, you can also become sotapanna or higher noble person. So number one, please remember saprita sansewa. Association with superior persons, noble persons. Okay, this is one necessary factor to become sotapanna or higher noble person. This is one condition that leads to realization of nirvana. Okay, then if you go to your country, then very difficult to find. Okay, those who can teach the way for realization of nirvana. Be careful. Then number two. One thing, okay, opposites. Okay, opposites. When you associate with bad person, what will happen? You cannot realize nirvana. Even you can fall into vocal states. You know? And like, for example, last time I also explained Ajatasattu that you can. Actually, he has parami seeds. He has already fulfilled 10 paramis until he can realize nirvana in this life. But he associated with Venerable Divaranda. Because of Venerable Divaranda's encouragement, he killed his father. After killing his father, although he can listen, he could listen to the Samanya Vilasoda, he could not become, he didn't become Sotapanna or higher noble person. Okay? If he didn't kill his father, sure, after listening to the Samanya Vilasoda, he would become Sotapanna. But he missed this opportunity. Okay? This one, why? What is the reason? He associated with bad persons, not good persons. So be careful to associate with good persons. Be careful not to associate with bad persons. Okay? When you, for example, when you associate with the drunkard, what will happen? He will encourage, oh, drink the wine or whiskey are very good. Oh, okay, I also need to test. Then you will test. Then you will become a drunkard. Very easy to understand, okay? Then, number two factor. Sadhamma Sawana. Sadhamma Sawana. Hearing the true Dhamma. Regarding the Four Noble Truth. Hearing the Dhamma regarding the Four Noble Truth. This is also one condition that lead to realization of nirvana, or that lead to the realization of the true or strength entry or I am noble person. Okay? When you can associate with the noble when you can associate with superior person, good person, sure, you will be able to listen to the true Dhamma regarding the Four Noble Truths from them. Okay? They are also giving the Dhamma law. They are also teaching the Dhamma according to the Bogas teaching. Okay? So you can also listen to the Dhamma from them. You can also listen to the Dhamma from them. Sadhamma Sawana. This is also very important factors Dubikan saudara pana ohaya nubat pasien. Why? Without listening to the Dhamma regarding the full noble truth, nobody can realize Nibbana. That's why you should listen to the Dhamma. You should listen to the Dhamma regarding the full noble truth. I will explain how this kirtan is important. You know, Gandharva Sariputta, Gandharva Moggallana. Let's talk also and briefly explain. Gandharva Sariputta to be, his name was Upadesa. Moggallana to be, his name was Polita. They are very good friends. Before appearance of the Buddha, they were searching for this lesson. They were searching for Nibbana. And during this time, there were six kinds of famous persons who confessed as Buddha. Then they also approach one of these six counterfeit Buddha, artificial Buddha, Buddha. Who are they? They are Purana Kasapa, Maitali Kosala, Ajita Kesa Kabala, Prabhupada Kechayana, Nikanda Nada Bhosa, Purana Pume Jipa, Nikanda Nada Bhosa, Sanjaya Pilata Bhosa, altogether six verses. Polita and Moggallana approached to among these six teachers, great teachers, Sanjaya Pilada Buddha. They approached Sanjaya Pilada Buddha to study his teaching. Okay, when they study the teaching of Sanjaya Pilada Buddha, they understand this teaching within short time. Then they also realize there's a low essence in his teaching. So they need to continue to find the deathlessness of Nibbana. Then the Buddha appear in the world. When the Buddha appear in the world, the Buddha preached the first sermon, Dhammacakka Bodhana Sutta in, Varanasi country. Vigadavana forest in Varanasi country. Then after Dhammacakka Bodhana Sutta and another Lagana Sutta, then five Panchavakya bhikkhu, a group of five bhikkhus became Arahanta. So after sometimes, Yasa and his friend group also became Arahanta, altogether about 60 Arahanta in the world. Then the Buddha encouraged them to propagate the sasana in the world. Then they went to Rajaka country. Venerable Asaji also went to Rajaka country together with the Buddha. Then he went to Rajaka city for ants food. Then Venerable Sariputta to be, Upadesa saw him. Upadesa saw him. Oh, he must have the Dhamma. He must have the true Dhamma. He must have the true Dhamma. He will have the true Dhamma. Then he approached and asked him, to whom referring to you ordained, okay? Then you ordain, referring to whom? Oh. Then, Venerable Ajahn answer, I ordain, referring to the Gotama Buddha. What kinds of Dhamma is as he teaches? Then Venerable Ajahn answers briefly, I just newly ordained in this book in his sadhana, so I don't know his dhammas too much. So he only just answer one sentence. You know, ye dhamma, ye dhamma, bhava, kesan, ye dhamma, dhamma, gato, aha, kesan, jaya, nirodo, evan, wadi, mahasanano, aha, one sentence. Ye dhamma, ye dhamma, bhava. This sentence refer to, you know, Samudaya Sajja and Samudaya Sajja, oh sorry, Yeda Mahedoka Bhava, this sentence refers to Dukkha Sajja. All dhammas, all formations arise because of cause. Okay? Beginning from cause. Yeda Hedunga Gadoha, the Buddha also preached their causes. Oh, this sentence, second sentence refers to Samudaya Sajja, the nowhere to all, the origin of sufferings. But at the end of this two stanza, you know, Upadesa became a sort of bhana. Esa hino nagagado aha. E tenza yo nirodo. Okay? E tenza yo nirodo. This sentence refers to two noble truths, you know, Nirodha Sajja and Magga Sajja. Evam Vadi Mahasamana Ahara, Mahasamana Gautama Buddha preached such kinds of Dhamma. Oh. He only just answered, after listening to the half of the stanza, you know, Upadesa became Sotapanna person. Then when he realized Nibbana, when he became Sotapanna noble person, what happened? Then he also went to his friend, Kalika, Venerable Paklana Dubi. Then as soon as Kalika see his friend, he understood, okay, he already found out the deathlessness, the real Dhamma, okay? Then He also shares his dhamma by reciting this stanza. At the end of this stanza, he also became Sotapanna person. Oh, so Venerable Sai Buddha and Venerable Moggallana to be became Sotapanna at the end of this stanza. Then we, you know, great chief disciple, Agasavaka, actually they have already fulfilled 10 paramis, one Atentia and 100,000 walls. Although they have fulfilled 10 parami, one Atentia and 100,000 walls, without listening to the Dhamma, they couldn't realize Nibbana. They couldn't begin Sotapanna or Payana noble persons. So, you know, even such kinds of Agasavaka chief disciple need two lessons to the Dhamma regarding the four noble truths. So how we can say this, okay? Every person needs two lessons to the Dhamma regarding the four noble truths. That's why we call Pratokosa. Pratokosa means need to listen the song of the Dhamma from other people. Or then you can also become a noble person. Okay? Then, hearing the true Dhamma is necessary for us to become Sotapanna or higher level persons. Higher level persons up to Arahanta stage. So you should try to listen to the Dhamma. You should try to study the Buddha's teaching, Vinaya, Sutta, Abhidhamma. Try to read, try to listen, try to study. Okay? Then you will have one condition to become Sotapanna or higher level person. Sadhamma Savana. Okay? Sadhamma Savana, you need to listen to the Dhamma. You need to study. Don't be lazy. Okay? You need to read at this. Then another one, number three, careful attention. Careful attention or proper attention, wise attention. What is wise attention? Yoni so manasikara, no? Yoni so manasikara. Yoni so manasikara is careful attention, proper attention or wise attention. You should also have this condition or this fetas to become Sotapanna or higher level persons. If you don't have this fetas, although you can associate with the noble person, although you can listen to the Dhamma, then what will happen? It is impossible to become Sotapanna or higher level persons. So you should also have Yonisomanasikara, proper attention, wise attention, careful attention. You know, careful attention is me. You associate with Kopasen. You can also listen to the Dhamma. But you have no wise attention. If you have no wise attention, even you can hold the wrong view. Even you can hold the wrong view. You know, last Dhamma talk, we also explained one Upasaka in Varanasi country. He practiced 32 years of the body for 30 years. Then, although he practiced for 30 years, then he hasn't attained any attainment. Then, he holds the wrong view, or the Buddha teaching will not lead to realization of Nibbana. Then, even he criticized the Buddha. Then, after pursuing what happened, he began crocodile ghost, Peter, that is. In the same way, you know, Venerable Devadatta, he also associated with Gopasins, like the Buddha or Venerable Sariputta. He also listens to the Dhamma from the Buddha. But he had wrong ionis of Nasikara, you know, unwise attention or improper attention. He wants to become famous. Then what happened? He want to become a Buddha, then he tried to kill the Buddha. He also encouraged Ajahnata to attempt the Buddha, okay? To kill his father, etc. He also tried to kill the Buddha. But his attempt was not successful. After he passed away, what happened? He fell into Ovisi hell. Oh, and now he has been in Ovisi hell. So now you are also seeing the Ovisi Venerable Devadatta and Ovisi hell. Did you see? Okay, because of this wrong association, sorry, improper attention. He has no Yonisom Nasikara, proper attention. He had wrong attention, Ayonisomanasikara. So, Yonisomanasikara is the proximate cause for all kusala. Whatever kusalas arise in you because of Yonisomanasikara, you know, proper attention, careful attention, wise attention. Whatever evil things arise in you, then because of Ayonisomanasikara, wrong attention. Wrong attention. Okay? Lobha, greed, hate, dosa, hatred, moha, delusion. They arise because of improper attention. Whatever kusala arises in you because of proper attention. For example, even you see, for example, handsome or beautiful persons, what will happen? If you have improper attention, you will have attachment, greed, etc. Okay? Then if you have proper attention, you will be able to discern asubha, formless meditation. Oh, discernment of formless meditation, asubha meditation is called proper attention. Then because of this proper attention, your nisamana sikara, akusala will not arise, only kusala will arise. In the same way, when you see ungreeable persons, okay, this greeable persons, ungreeable objects, this greeable object, but you have your nisamana sikara, then you only just reflect on this, then hatred, dosa will not appear in your mind. Oh, because of yoniso manasikara, proper attention. If you have yoniso manasikara, improper attention, sure, you will get angry. Oh, in the same way, mana, esa, materia, or akusala arise because of yoniso manasikara, improper attention. All kusala arise. Now you are fulfilling the values, morality, because of yoniso manasikara. You are practicing meditation because of yoniso manasikara. If you have no yoniso manasikara, the practice of meditation is useless. Okay, I will enjoy with the sensual pleasure without practicing any meditation, then finish. Then you cannot realize nirvana. Okay? That's why yoniso manasikara, kaya attention, proper attention is one condition that lead to realization of nirvana. Or to become sotapanna or higher noble person. Okay? And fulfill these conditions. Another one. Number four, Dhamma Lu Dhamma Patipati. Practice in accordance with the Dhamma. You know, practice in accordance with the Dhamma. Dhamma Lu Dhamma Patipati can be divided into two walks, you know, Dhamma and Anu Dhamma Patipati. Dhamma means, you know, nine kinds of Logopara Dhamma, Supra Mundane Dhamma. Then four past knowledges, four prudent knowledges, and Nibbana. All together, nine Dhamma are called Logopara Dhamma, Supra Mundane Dhamma. Okay? If you wish to attain such kinds of supramundane dhamma, practice in accordance with the dhamma. Practice according to the dhamma. Okay? That means, if you wish to become sotapanna or higher noble person, you need to practice the dhamma according to the Buddha's teaching. Now, for example, you are associating with the good persons, number one. Here in the true Dhamma, you can also listen to the Dhamma regarding the four noble truths. Number three, yoniso manasikara, you also have yoniso manasikara. Oh, okay, yoniso manasikara. Actually, yoniso manasikara here refer to, you know, the vipassana knowledge. Especially personal knowledge. Personal knowledge, anicca and nibbana, yoniso manasikara. When you see anicca, when you see as anicca and conditions, you know, sankhara formations, then this is also yoniso manasikara. Actually, service sankhara, anicca, all conditions are impermanent. So you also see all conditions as impermanence. That will be yoniso manasikara. All formation is impermanent. That was it, when you saw Manasika. All formations are impermanent, impermanent, but impermanent is permanent. That will be Ayonisa of Manasika. In the same way, Doki Sukhandi, when you pay attention, the Doka is Sukha, happiness, that will be Ayonisa of Manasika. When you see the Doka is Doka, that will be Ayonisa of Manasika. Another, Nansa. In the same way, when you pay attention, all formation is Nansa, that will be Ayonisa of Manasika. But when you pay attention, all formation is Sa. Nansa, another is Sa, or soul, that will be Ayonisa of Manasika. In the same way, Asubhati, Ayonisa of Manasika, when you pay attention, Asubha is Asubha, that will be Ayonisa of Manasika. When you pay attention, Asubha is Subha, or beauty, that will be Ayonisa of Manasika. Okay? Then, commentary directly mentioned like this. But you only just briefly remember, when you have pusala, whatever pusala arise in you, there will be Ayonisa of Manasika. Whatever pusala arise in your mind, there will be Ayonisa of Manasika. Okay? Then although you have Ayonisa of Manasika, by practices, okay, meditations, we can realize Nibbana, we can become Sotavana, higher person, you know. But you don't practically practice meditation. You don't practically fulfill three trainings of Noble Eightfold Path. Then it is also impossible to become Sotavana, higher Noble persons, especially nowadays. During the Buddha times, when they lessons to the short sutta or long sutta. After listening to those suttas, they can become sotapanna or higher noble persons. But nowadays, it is impossible to become sotapanna or higher noble persons by listening the Dhamma. So they need to practice meditation practically. They need to fulfill three trainings, they need to practice Noble Eightfold Path, step by step, systematically, and they realize Nibbana. Okay? So, three trainings. You know three trainings. Sila Sika, training and moral ambition. Samadhi Sika, training and concentration. Panya Sika, training and wisdom. All together, three trainings. When you can fulfill this three training, when you can practice this three training, then you can become Sotapanna or higher noble persons. Okay? Higher noble persons. So how to fulfill? You know the sila for lay persons, five precepts, special sila are necessary to fulfill. For bhikkhu, bhikkhu sila, for siyale, siyale sila, for yogi, 8 precepts or 10 precepts, etc. Those are sila. Okay? When you can fulfill the sila, when you can maintain 5 precepts, then you automatically maintain Pirokaya Dojirita, Vaji Dojirita, or Bhava Bhattashna, bodily perfections and Bhava perfections. Okay, then you become noble person. You become co-person. You become co-person. When you can become co-person, when you can maintain 5 precepts not to break, although you cannot attain Nibbana in this life, although you cannot attain, for example, concentration in this life, don't worry, you will never fall into full stage. Okay, sila will support you to be reborn in good rank, Dimya rank or Diva rank, etc. So, this is the power of sila. Okay? Don't worry, only just trying to maintain 5 precepts not to break. Okay? Then the respective silas, not to break. Then, based on your morality, you should also try to practice meditation to take concentration or samadhi sikha and concentration. For example, by practicing sanapana meditation, you can also take up to four jhana stage. Then practice until you attain four jhana. Then when you attain the four jhana, you have concentration, samadhi. When you have concentration, okay, you only just stay with meditation objects for a long time. When you can stay with meditation objects for a long time, then no defilement will appear. You can stay peacefully, try and tell it to respect the jhana. Okay? Sanapanasati. Then this is also the power of concentration, samadhi sikha. But don't start with the concentration, continue to practice penya sikha. Penya sikha, insight meditation, vipassana meditation based on concentration. Penya sikha, when you have concentration, okay, established concentration, based on this concentration, practice four elements in your body. You know the earth element, water element, fire element, and wind element in your body. Then you will see a group of four elements in your body. You will not see as human being, you will not see as male or female. Then what will happen? You can also see the many small particles collapse when you attain this concentration stage. Okay? Then you should continue to discern four elements in those collapses. Then you can also continue to discern derived materiality, upadarupa, and those respective kalapa. Then you start to realize anima reality, paramatta rupa. Then based on paramatta rupa, then you can also continue to practice nama, nama meditation. Then when you can see nama and rupa clearly in detail, then actually you realize dukkha saccha, you penetrate the dukkha saccha, the noble truth of suffering. Okay? When you penetrate the dukkha saccha, the noble truth of suffering, then you should try to continue to find their causes. For example, when you discern nama and rupa, then you know there's no female or male, there's no human being or deva, no Brahma, only nama and rupa. But you still have wrong view. For example, this nama and rupa were created by God or created by kinds of persons, for example, Allah or created by Brahma, Brahma or something like this. They have such kinds of wrong view in the world. Okay? Then you should try to find their causes. And when you can systematically practice, you will be able to find out their causes. What are their causes? For example, now you are a human being. You accumulated kusala in the past. Because of this past kusala, then you became a human being now. If you have accumulated this kusala in the past, if kusala produced you will become maybe animal or ghost or heaviness like this. But now you are a human being, that's why Shua, one kind of kusala karma produced to be a human being. You are a kamavasara being, so your karma, first karma will be kamavasara kusala karma. Maybe this kusala karma will be generosity, dana, or sila, virtues, or bhavana, meditation practice. A kind of meditation, for example, okay, a kind of kusala. A kind of kusala. A kind of kusala, you have many experiences in this thing. For example, even when you pay respect to the Sangha, only just pay respect to the Sangha, then this karma can produce to be a human being. For example, one yogi is practicing development or generation. When he discerns the first past life, Then he was maybe a tree deva. A tree deva. Rauka deva. Then many sanghas, many people sangha went to the village for high school. At the night he respect, maybe he climbed down from the tree and respected the sangha. He didn't offer anything, he only just paid respect to the sangha. Okay? All this karma produced to be a human being in this life. Or like this. In the same way, there are also many different kinds of karma. Some person, they only just offer the flower to the Buddha. This karma produced to become a human being. Some person, they only just listen to the Dhamma, only just listen to the Dhamma, or they also became a human being in this life. Or some person, they only just maintain practice, not to pray, then this karma also produce. Some person, they only just develop the Buddha's quality, or the Buddha's quality produce to become a human being. Or such kinds of karma are all karmavasara karma. Or. So, okay? Don't underestimate. Even very small karma, it can produce to be a human being, to be reborn in a human being or divara. Okay? If you can maintain five pieces, not to break, sure, you can choose whatever rank you like among the divara and human rank. Among this divara, what kinds of rank do you prefer? Okay, you can choose, but don't break five precepts. Okay? Don't break five precepts. I have already taken how to do. You break them like this. Okay, don't be this if you are already breaking. Okay? From now on, try to fulfill five precepts, not to break. Oh. Okay, then this, when you can find out their causes in the past, for example, when you are doing such kinds of kusala, you may have intentions to become human being or kinds of life. For example, human being, I want to become bhikkhu or siyali, you may have such kinds of intentions. Then you did kusala in the past. Then, actually, there's no real bhikkhu and no real siyali, no real human being, only a group of nama and rupa, or five aggregates. But you know as human being, bhikkhu or siyali. Or this kind of knowing is called ignorance, awaita, wrong beauty. Ignorance. Awaita. You have attachment to bhikkhu life or siyali life or human being, there will be craving, dana. You have strong attachment to bhikkhu life or siyali life or human being, there will be clinging, upadana. Or with these three defilement rounds, you accumulate a kind of kusala. You offer food to the Buddha or the Sangha, you develop Buddha's quality, or you respect the Sangha, etc. Then there will be Sankhara, formation. After doing this kusala, there will be karma sati, karma afos. Then you have these five causes. If you have these five causes, sure, these five causes will produce to be a human being, to be a bhikkhu, or to be a siyali, or to be a human being, etc. Or when you know this condition, these five causes, then you will realize samudaya sajja, the noble truth or the origin of suffering. Okay? These dukkha sajja and samudaya sajja are the objects of vipassana. Or the objects of vipassana. When you see those noble truths, then you also see their nature. What are their nature? Their nature is rising and passing away, rising and perishing. Then pay attention, rising and perishing or those for formation, then you can contemplate them as anicca, anicca, impermanence, impermanence. Dukkha, dukkha, suffering, suffering. Nasa, nasa, nada, nada, etc. Then what will happen? Then this is called vipassana meditation and silent meditation. When you are practicing this Vipassana meditation, you also describe the defilements gradually. Then your Vipassana knowledge become mature. At the end of the maturation stage of Vipassana knowledge, then you will realize Nibbana. When you realize Nibbana, or the first knowledge that realizes Nibbana is called Sotapatti Phala's knowledge. Okay? Sotapatti. That means you will become Sotapanna. Sotapanna person. When you realize Nibbana with the first knowledge, you know, Sotapatti Phala's knowledge, then this Sotapatti Phala's knowledge describes all defilements which can cause for Kuku state. Oh, all defilements. Loba, desire, loba, desire, dosa, desire, moha. But their loba, dosa, moha is weak. Because of loba, dosa, moha, they will not kill the human being, they will not see others properly, they will not do such a misconduct, etc. Okay? That's why they will never pray five precepts. Although they see loba, dosa, moha. But they also completely destroy deity, wrong you, and ujikesa. Ujikesa, doubt regarding the Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha. Oh. They themselves realize Nibbana. That's why they don't need to find the teacher. Okay, they don't need to find any other teachers from the Buddha's rather than the Buddha's dispensation. You know, they will not find any teachers from outside dispensation. They understand themselves, okay? They don't need to see many teachers' face. They understand themselves, they realize themselves, that's why. Or they can only find the teacher or in the Buddha's dispensation. Even the Buddha's dispensation also, if someone are teaching wrongly, or they don't need to find such kinds of wrong teacher also. They understand itself. Okay? Oh. When you become Sotapanna person, what will happen? Well, there are many qualities of Sotapanna. Okay? Yeah. This one, number four, practice in accordance with the Dhamma V. This one. You should practice this three training. You know, Pinyasekami, beginning from the discernment of four elements until you realize Nibbana. This state is called Penya state wisdom. Penya seka training and wisdom. So, practice in accordance with the Dhamma B, practice these three training until you realize Nibbana. Or, until you realize Nibbana, then four conditions completed. When there are these four conditions, then you will become Sotapanna or higher noble person. Okay? Only just repeat after me. Okay, to memorize or to remember these four conditions. Number one, Sabhurisa Sansi Wo. Association with superior person. Sadhamma Sawana.
Hearing the true Dhamma.
Yoniso Nazikaro.
Careful attention.
Dhamma Lu Dhamma Padipati. Practice in accordance with the Dhamma. Okay, if there are these four conditions, then you will become Sotapanna or higher noble person. By fulfilling these four conditions, may you be able to become Sotapanna or higher noble person. May you be able to attain Nibbana in this very life as soon as possible. Only just four conditions, but it takes for more than 1 hour. Do you have any questions? No question. No question.
Is there any question? Okay.
One more question.
Oh.
One person is when practicing and the karma chanda, lopa dosa and
winsa
arise. So does it become a karma? Mm-hmm. Only think about the. Some thought about lopa and dosa wrong thoughts arise, so is it become a karma or not?
Oh, you mean, for example, thinking about sexual pleasure, then lopa is arising in this part. Thinking about evil, and then anger, dosa is arising in his mind.
Yes.
Then this is a karma or not?
Yes.
Only just thinking about in mind is called mano docharita, mental actions.
Mental action, sorry, you use money. Okay?
But then, can have fruit? Can have fruit because of that karma or not?
Oh, mano dukserita also can produce the results. But, you know, all actions start beginning from mano karma, mental actions. For example, you have attachment to someone or something like this. Because of this attachment, very strong attachment, lava, they were see others' property. They were doing sexual misconduct, etc. Oh, this one starting from mano dukkha. If they can stop with the mano dukkha, still okay. They will not bring five precepts. Dosa, okay, if they have dosa, anger in their mind, based on this anger, they will kill living being. Or they will also abuse other people, they will also accuse lower person, etc. Then what will happen? Then they do everything. All dochirita, kadochirita, ujitochirita, and manodochirita. But if they stop in manodochirita, it's still okay. Compared to the other. Sure, if there's a lava is arising in their mind, this is also Akusala, sure. Dosa is arising in their mind, this is also Akusala. But Sally or females become Arhanta, they still can maintain their lifespan or not? Oh, yes, Sally, how do you think? Yeah. And if I answer, they cannot maintain, then they will be afraid of practice and magician. Don't worry. Okay, there. If they are wearing the, you know, some kinds of robe, wearing the free back, then although they become Aranda, they still can last long. They still can maintain their lifespan. Well, there are many such kinds of idea, but there may be some different kinds of ideas. A little bit different ideas. But don't worry, you can practice and you become Aranda. Okay? As long as you are wearing the robes, okay, and then you still can maintain your lifespan, although you are silly. But lay persons, lay patients, maybe female or male, when they began, okay, regarding this question, do you see what you listen from many another Dhamma talk here? Manose is an intimate word. Iba wicita iba soda panabi honti segala dengan itu lagi anak kami pelangi harada pelangi kamu nanti. Dengan bikin soda bana oh hayan lebih pasti aku beranda say as a lay pasti. Soda bana dia jawab sih mesti nanti. Benda bikin soda bana segala dengan itu anak kami. They can live until their lives can finish as a lay person. Okay? As a lay person. Kina Zawabana, Brindai Bhaya Diva, Babasin Diva. But when they become Arahanta as a lay person, they need to take final Brindai Bhaya. Or they should ordain as people or not they say Ali. Okay? Begu Babasan Diva. They are mentioned Babasan Diva Viyam, only just ordination. It does not mention maybe Begu or Beguni or something like this. Ordained persons. Then when you ordain, then you can also, you still can maintain your lifespan. Don't worry. Okay? Kacama, Radha Nama Siddha Kuno, Healing and Hina, when they cannot exist until their lives can finish as a lay person. Radha Nama Siddha Kuno, Radha Phala is the superior qualities. Healing and Bana Hina, human being or the lay person's appearance is imperial. Labor sense appearance in imperial. So that Hina they are over Nakuna Baritona said for the because of this reason they cannot maintain they cannot carry the superior quality the superior dharma. Because of this reason three Nagu Kamawa Babasini Kamawa. Okay? They will take Prinivana or they should become Begu or ordained person. They should ordain. But if they are past karma, when they become Arahanta, although they want to ordain, they cannot ordain. For example, Bahiya Dharusjiriya, you know? After listening to short dhamma from the Buddha, he became Arahanta. Then, because of his past karma, he requested to be a bhikkhu from the Buddha. But the Buddha knew his past karma. That's why the Buddha asked him to find the rope and bow to ordain. Then he went to find the rock and bow, and on the way he was hit by Okas, Yaka, you know, Okres, because of his past karma. Then he could not ordain, he passed away, all like this. Okay? And now I understand. If I explain here, Hari.
My question is regarding reading Dhamma. Reading Dhamma. Is it included in hearing true Dhamma?
Reading Dhamma. Hearing the true Dhamma is in. They only just translate here. Hearing the true Dhamma. We only just listen to the Dhamma. Not only like this. You study the Dhamma. You read the Dhamma. You discuss the Dhamma, all are included in this condition, this fetters. Okay? Number one, hearing the true Dhamma, Sadhamma Savana. Sadhamma Savana means not only hearing, also lesson, also study, Tipitaka, the Buddha's teaching, or like this meditation practice, those all are included. Do you still have question? Any questions?
About Sapurisa, now how can we know who is Sapurisa?
Just now, I already explained Buddha and Buddha's disciple, they are Sapurisa.
But now, how we can know who is Sukhavanna or another
Okay, so that, if you don't know, then you try to have such kinds of ability. You try to know, okay, who are Sotapanna or the noble persons. Okay, if you have no ability, no need to worry. You only just approach the person who can teach the Dharma. But in the, you know, with the Vipaka cannot be mentioned. If you cannot associate with the noble persons, you can also associate with them. Those who attain jhana-labhi, we call jhana-labhi persons. If you cannot associate with jhana-labhi persons, you should also associate with the Tipitaka. Because since they have learned Tipitaka, they also know the way to Nibbana. Although maybe they may not realize Nibbana yet, but they can show the way to Nibbana. For example, like Venerable Siva, you know Venerable Siva, he taught the Buddha's teachings for a long time. He was still Puttocana, ordinary person, but many thousands of his students became Arahanta under his teaching. So you can also associate with for example, Tipitaka Dharapas, or they can also teach. If you can associate with the Tipitaka Dharap, then you can also associate with the Dvipitaka Dharap. If you can associate with Dvipitaka Dharap, Ekapitaka Dharap, although they don't memorize Tipitaka, then those who have Priyaki knowledge, or they can also teach the Dharma. Oh. That means the first, to associate the best person to associate with is the Buddha. Okay, the skin, the next, the best person to associate is Arahanta, like this. Maybe great disciple or chief disciple, like this. Otherwise, reduce slowly, Anagami, Sagadagami, Sodabana, or Tipitaka, or Jhana Labhi, Tipitaka, Tipitaka, etc. Like this. But to associate with noble person is the best. Then it is sure, because they have already realized Nibbana, they can show the way to realize Nibbana. Okay, if there's no questions, good questions, then we should start our Dhamma discussion. Rupi Akrami Pusha, our merits to all beings. Kidani Pongyan, Asawa Kaya, Sana Odu, Kidani Pongyan, Nibhanasa, Pichayo, Odu, Mama Pongya Bhaga, Sabha Sadhana, Ajivi, Bhagavan, Bhagavan, Lavandu.